There are about 1,800 think tanks in the U.S., so it is the country with the largest number of think tanks in the world. The reasons for that are deeply embedded in the political history and culture of the United States. The view in terms of that from the very inception of the Republic, which is not a current Republican or conservative mantra, a government that governs best, governs least, goes back to the very inception of our Republic. Additionally, when de Tocqueville came to the United States in its early years, was struck by all of the factions he described, which were both civic, religious, etc., and how they were engaged in the political process. The fact that there is a tax code that encourages support for independent institutions. So in the US there is a vibrant civil society, largely made possible because if I contribute to a nonprofit, to a civil society organization, my tax burden is reduced, commensurate with the contribution. And so that creates independent means of support and also encourages the development and proliferation of civil society organizations. So those are just a few of the reasons, but it is also a part of our political process that is decentralized. There's federal government, state government, and local government. And so all of that contributes and encourages interaction and the need for ideas and input, and all of that contributes to the large number of think tanks in the US. The first is clearly climate change. I mean, because the work I do is global, climate change is clearly one of the paramount issues from country to country. The growing discontent and inequality and the gap between rich and poor and how to bridge that gap is a second central focus. The implications of and disruptions caused by the fourth industrial revolution, which is AI, is another key question that across institutions. And the other is how to, which was represented here at CBRE in our discussion today among the think tanks in Brazil, is how do you find new means of support? How do you maintain independence? How do you effectively not only produce research but communicate it and communicate it effectively and strategically? So those are the sort of central issues that are in both the regional summits and the global summits. So, I mean, in terms of every country that I visit, and I've now visited 113 countries, and whenever I go, I meet with the think tanks and asked an institution like CBRE to organize the meeting, not so much so I can talk to them, but so I can listen and have a greater understanding of the challenges and opportunities they face. It is, from my standpoint, the immense challenges and opportunities that think tanks face can only be met by the community of think tanks in a country, in a region, and around the globe. And now for over 7 or 8 years, on the national, regional, and global level, initially when I started this, people didn't understand what I was doing and why I was doing it. Now people get that, you know, they are all in the same boat. They have both major policy challenges that they need to grapple with, but more importantly, from an institutional perspective, they have strategic and operational challenges, unclear how they can meet them. And through the conversations we had here today, that you hear from others of how they're meeting those challenges, you see best practices, you're able to connect with your colleagues, and you combat the feeling that as an institution or an individual, you're not doing this alone. And that's the most important and valuable part.